So we are going to do the granny square with one cut out at the minute. So we start off with the slip knot with a size 4mm hook. So we're going to slip knot four. So we've got one, two, three, four. So we will connect the top end with the first one. Then we have a tiny, tiny circle there. So within this circle, we're going to make 16 trebles within the circle. As we're going round, we will be holding the tail as we're going round, so we're tucking it in. So we'll go to treble now. So we'll do three, one, two, three. And yarn over. We're going to the center of the circle and pull. Okay, so we will do 16 all the way around. Make sure the tension is quite strong. And as we are going around, we will be tucking this tail end in. So we've done one, two, three. Four. Five. Six, seven, eight. As you see, I'm tucking this as we go along. We are tucking the tail in, it's because at the end we would like to pull this so it can close the hole. So we're on our 16 now. So what we need to do is connect the two ends together. We'll go into the first and just do a slip knot there and come through. So we've got the center and our tail here, so we'll need to close it up. We'll just pull it, so this will be the back. So that's our centre of the granny square. Now into the next row. The next row, we'll go up three. One, two, three. So what we need is to go back in here with another treble. And the next one along is we're going to do two trebles in each hole. So we will yarn over, treble one in, but we're not going to cast off. We'll do the first one. So instead of casting off, we're going to go back in and come through, yarn over, and then we should have four. We'll go through the first two, then we have three, okay, first two, and this all the way across again. So we go up one, yarn over, we're going to the next row. Okay, over and through the first two, but we would finish normally here, but we'll go back in, roll over, and go in. Again, we have four. Go over, we'll go over two, take two. Go over and take all three. And then we'll go up one, go up one. So we're going to go to the next box. Go in. And go stitch. Now, we're going to go back in. Then we go over two. There we go, baby. All three. Again, we go up one, one in, go to the next one, yarn over, in, then we've got three, we go through two, but we go back in again, yarn over, back in, got four again, go through the first two, and three. Again, we go up one. So we keep repeating this all the way around. We've ended one. Go over two. Yarn over and back into the same hole. Okay. So go through the first two, and the next one we'll go through all three. So I'm going to repeat this all the way around till we get to the end here, and then we connect the two together. So I've got to the last one now, so we need to connect the two ends together. The last slip knot, we go underneath, put it through. And now we connected. Now we're going to the fourth row. So now we do treble in each, three in each row. So one, go up one, three, and we go back in. Just a normal treble, and then we go back into the same one. And we move along to the one beside it, and then we do another three. Another three to the same hole. Can you see the pattern? I'll just continue all the way around. Trebles in each one. So we've got to the end now. We need to connect the two. And we have a circle which we need to change into a square. Right, so we slip knot, four, go up four, two, over knot four, we wrap two over, back in the same hole. And we come through. Three, two, wrap around three again, two, sorry, go in, two, two. So we've put four slip knots there, and then we'll go up two. One, two, and over again twice. We're going to go back into the same hole. It looks a bit uneven, but it will work itself out in a minute. And up two. So we do another three, four, so last one. So that'll be the corner there, and then we're going to do treble into over one, and we'll bring the corners in. So I can do three of them. Back in again. And again. Can you see that corner there? So that would be one corner of the square. And then we're going to continue along. Another three here. So that, so that's one area done, that's the top, say, and there's a corner there. Now I've done three trebles. Mind the third one, I'm going to do another corner with four, can bring it in. And now the corner we're going to wrap twice. So when I've done three, I'm going to go up two, then three, four, one. So I'm going to go up one, two, and again, wrap two. So go back into the same hole again to bring the corner around. And I want three again there. That's one, two, and three again. Now I'm going to continue on here, doing the treble again. So I've done three along. So now I'm in another corner. So my third corner here, and go around twice. So we've just done the third corner here. You can see the square is shaping up. And then we just need to continue. The fourth corner will be there. Just continue with three trebles again. On the last corner now. So down three, so we go up two. Two. So our last corner is nearly done. So we have three to complete there, and we have a full square. So the circle's converted into a square. But I must say, your tension must be very, very tight. Always check your tension when you're pulling the yarn. So I completed three, and now we just connect the first corner we completed with the rest of the line. That's clear. So now we're going to do another row with just trebles on there. So we go up 1, 2, 3. So we're going to do trebles in each one for 3. Just a simple go here to the corner. We're going to do another set of three in the corner. So we've gone around the corner now, and then we go back to here, and we're going to do three to bring the edges in. Make sure your tension is fairly consistent. And then we're going to continue all the way around. On the last stretch, and don't forget to change your hook at the last row, so you could be, you can see this is a lot bigger than the end and the edges, so we can bring it in together and it looks neater. So I started off with 4.5 and I'm finishing off with 3.5. If you've got a four hook, start with a four hook and then finish with a three. Well, I've just got 4.5 and finish off with 3.5. There we go, and now slip knot to the end. And that is our square, our granny square there, the front, the back, and we'll just tuck this in at the end. This is one kind of colour granny square. If you wanted to change colours, you can change colours every time you do a row, and we'll do that on the next video.